So guys, we are coming close to this supermarket again. They are much cheaper in price because they are located in very crazy outskirts. And I want to ask you if in Serbia it's the same, these kind of shops located in the outskirts of the cities. So poor people, no, not poor, low-income people come to such places, you know, but not also poor, but some people who wants to buy cheaper and they have a car. Oh yeah, I found this shop, you see, Svetofor. Okay, we need to, it's like in some factory area. You see, here is a cement factory, but we have to go to the left. Oh my god, it's crazy roads here. So we have to go here. You see, crazy, but it should be cheaper. Also, they sell some, like, you know, second-class material, products, you know, from not famous companies, like, if it's like milk products, it's like often from some cheaper companies. Yeah, you see, but BMW even coming here. Yeah, here is this shop. Let's park a car somewhere first. Yeah, you see some factory zone here area. Okay, here it is, the famous Svetofor, the most budget supermarket in Russia, and now they went to the international market. Okay, let's go check it out. So as you can see guys, this supermarket located in some factory area, but people come here by cars to buy lots of products at once, you know, so not only low-income people come here. You see, Svetofor, supermarket of low prices, it says here. But okay, let's go and buy something over there. Oh, beer. Stepan Razin, the famous Russian guy who tried to take the power in the country. You guys, here it's like they sell vegetables, but it's not the supermarket yet. Here it starts. Okay guys, let's explore the supermarket, and now we see the cart. You see, no 10 rubles coins. Tucker Carlson would be saddened by this fact, but yes, let's go. You can see how it looks like, very simple design. It also helps to save, to keep prices low. And first we see the hand soap. You see, for such big bottle you would pay just $1.98. And now we see huge powders bags, for example this no name brand, 9 kilogram, would cost us, called Sapphire powder, $4.45. How much it cost in your countries? You see, it looks like some Ariel, some capitalist Western brand, but in reality it's like some no-name brand. But I think it's good enough, you know. Okay, let's explore the area. You see simple carton boxes here. And here's the laundry soap, 3 liters, $1.04.
You see, they sell in very big packages here. Reminds me of America. But Americans use this weird measure systems. And what here awaits us? Oh, shampoo, you see. 39 cents. Not bad. Let's go further. Guys, do you have such kind of similar stores in your countries? I know this store opened in Serbia as well. Wow. But this is interesting. You see, it's for women, my woman subscribers, women's pads, 80 pieces just for 89 cents. So it's like basically 1 cent for one woman pad, you know. I won't surprise you if my woman subscribers would rush to move to Russia after seeing such prices for women's pads. And you see here the toilet paper, very simple package. Packed, but you know, if it does a job, like, what's the problem? And not expensive, $1.38 for 8 pieces. Looks like capitalist. I hope it just don't rip off, you know. Some football balls they sell here. Wow, and SpongeBob, boy, SpongeBob, Sponge, dear sponges, yeah, 63 cents for such a big pack, you see. And wow, here we see artificial turf, you know, it's like Americans, they're kind of addicted to the cutting grass, while you can just buy artificial grass. And here you see in this store everything, like, they sell frozen, like meat, fish, everything is frozen, so it would keep for longer price. And here they even sell the fish sperm called maloki, you know, some Russians and Scandinavian people love to eat it, but I didn't find it, so maybe it's sold off, because Russians love to eat this fish sperm. But here, for example, these two pieces of fish, what's the name of this fish? Barbot fish, yes, 1 kilogram, 650 grams, you see the price. Not expensive. Yes, but fish sperm I didn't find. And here, what we have here, guys, it's a where is the writing? I forgot what's that in English. Ground pork, yes, ground pork, like, you see, for such a piece, just $4.02. And here we see sausages, you see. For these three sausages, you're gonna pay 191 rubles. Or in dollars, it would be $3.12, salami sausage. So basically, for one stick of sausage would be just like $1. And here, like, some pork you can see, and so on, many different types, you know, and doesn't look that bad, you know, actually. Wow, and here it's like ham sausage, this stick, $3.79, but I'm gonna buy some small one, you see, just for 89 cents for such a piece of sausage. Here you can see some air conditioning, like this refrigerator stuff. They keep save money on it, on like fridges. And this is eyed fish, you see, it's named butterfly fish, you see, for such a price. My first time in my life see such like fish named butterfly design, you see. Just $1.08 for such a fish. You see, they probably like, yeah, split it, like folded, like Samsung fold, but this is fish fold. Okay, let's go farther. You know, it's kind of cold in this fridge, because this room, the whole room is like serves as this fridge. And here is the corn, guys, just 98 cents. You know, Nikita Khrushchev, general secretary of USSR, he was so addicted to corn, it's crazy. He made some American businessman a billionaire. He wanted to cultivate the corn in USSR, but they fucked up. You know, this experiment was very bad for USSR. You can read about it in Wikipedia. But this is cheese. You see, such piece of cheese called Tilsiter cost $2.42. Here we can see ketchup. I need ketchup. You see, it's like some no-name design brand, but it says Eco and costs just 60 cents. Let's try it, you know. Actually, I'm kind of picky for the ketchups usually, but yeah. Anyway, most of the brands here are not famous brands. So yeah, but what's that? I don't know if it's like dried blood. Yeah, it's kind of getting very cold in this room. And here is the butter. You see, they also sell butter in very big packages. That's how it helps to keep prices lower, you know. Yeah, this is half a kilogram cost $1.15. I wouldn't be surprised if like some government kindergartens or schools buy products here, you know, to save money on kids or students. Yes. Wow, and here we see pickles, cucumber pickles. You know, guys, cucumbers, fresh cucumbers nowadays cost so much that it's really cheaper to buy the pickles, you know. Cost just $3. You see, much cheaper than the fresh cucumbers. Okay, let's go farther. Here we see salt. You see, just 24 cents for such a pack. Yeah, you see some products for housewives. Oh, sorry, I'm not like, you know, against women, but yes. But this is the borscht. To cook borscht, you know, mixture, because I cook very bad. I wanna try to use it, you see. Just 67 cents. Yeah, I think I'll buy it. And what's here? Ah, it's a oatmeal. You see, 83 cents for 1 kilogram. Sounds like a good deal. How much it would cost in your countries? In Russia we say it like oatmeal, we call it Hercules, you know, in the name of the Greek god, so like son of God, so it means like you will be strong if you eat this oatmeal called Hercules. Wow, and here is the pasta, guys. You see, it looks like stars. 900 grams also, not 1 kilogram. Why 900 grams? They all kind of, but cost just half a dollar, you see. So sounds like a good deal and looks cool. So I think I'll buy it, you know. But let's go farther, you see. Here are some also stuff for household, not only product, not only food they sell here. Everything. And here is the proof that it's me filming it all for you. Trying for you, working for you. It's not the artificial intelligence doing for you. You see, and here is how it's called. Dried prunes, you see, $1.87, you know. You can see they don't sell fresh fruits here, but they sell like this long time saving stuff like dried or frozen or like pickles. But yeah, I'm gonna take it because I like it. And yes, here we can see poison against ants, all type of ants, you see, but you have to be careful in Russia. If even if you are human, you can be poisoned, you know. Like, if you invited to the tea in Russia to drink a tea, ask the inviter to drink your tea first, you know. Yeah, you see poison from insects. It's called number one, $1.21. Yes, it's not Novichok, but Novichok sold in other KGB shops, you know. But not in this one. In this one, just against tents. Yeah, you can see, you can even buy the rose tree, $1.82. Even the plant you can buy here in the store. Okay, and what's here? Here is like nut mixture. You see, kind of expensive. 381 rubles for like $4.08. But you know, I think I'll take it. Even though I might fart after it a lot, but you know, farting is natural, as Finnish and German people say. You have a stereotype like that about Germans, that it's natural to fart. And about Finnish also, a little bit. Sorry, my subscribers from these countries. I know there are many stereotypes, bad stereotypes about Russians as well. Cookies, you see, $2.21. You see, they sell like this in big packages cookies, which makes them cheaper. But I'll take these ones, cookies for tea, $1.20. For, it's 1 kilogram, yeah, 1 kilogram, 1,000 grams. So I'm gonna take it. Babushkas love to drink such cookies, to eat such cookies with tea, you know. But what's next? Yeah, you see in very big packages they sell here, which makes it cheaper. Yeah. But what else? What else? You see, they sell like this kind of long time saving products here. Very good for the apocalypse bunkers, you know, to be in such a shop. Long time saving products. You see, such a coffee packs with coffee packs inside cost $1.90. Which is not bad, you know. Let's go further. Oh wow, here is cacao called Leo. Leo means like lion in some languages. You see, cacao, it's not like Nesquik, you have lion. 94 cents for half a kilogram. Wow, and it's even written in English here. So maybe they're gonna sell it in Western countries, I don't know. But yeah, now you have Leo instead of Nesquik, you see. Maybe Nesquik still here, but I don't know. Yeah, you see, this is coffee. How much it cost? Classic coffee. $1.97 for 250 grams. I think I'll take it. You know, even though I'm kind of picky on coffee as well, but yes, I'll take it. Because I need to take something, you know. Yeah, but it's kind of no-name brands here. Yeah, and you see, if you want chief here to make like famous prisoners drink, Russian prisoners drink kefir, you need to buy such a tea. It costs just $1.83 for half a kilogram, you see. Simple tea. But, you know, I want some tea with some berries, because I have enough of black tea, but this tea in bags cost 49 cents. I don't see how many bags are there, I forgot. Yes, let's go further. Wow, here polyurethane foam, $4.53. You know, you better don't put this in some holes of your body. You know, there are such stories, bad stories, crazy stories. And here's the ice cream, you know, and pelmeni, and so on. You see, for example, such pack of pelmeni cost $1.17. But I doubt that it's a lot of meat inside, so I'm not gonna buy it. And you see some from American fashion, we now have these nuggets also in very big pack. They sell here in very big packs, guys. But I didn't find the price for it, maybe they didn't change the price tags, you know. And here, guys, we can see the tomatoes, pickled tomatoes as well. Tomato prices for fresh tomatoes, guys, also are crazy in Russia nowadays. So it's much cheaper to buy pickled tomatoes. You see, for such a big 3-liter bottle, just $2.94. And here we see the dog food, you see, called like 94 cents. And here, guys, I didn't even know such thing exists as diapers for animals. You see, $5.07 for diapers for animals. Quite expensive. And here is the cat food, you see, for almost 2 kilograms, $3.10. And here also, this, you know, American fashion potato for frying, $1.07. Or maybe not even from America, Americans stole it from Belgium. I've heard in Belgium French fries are popular, even though they're called French. Yeah, and this is again beer, Stepan Razin, the famous Russian rebel, you know, who tried to take power from the Tsar, Alexei Mikhailovich, in the... I forgot the century, you know, guys, in 17th century, I think. And, yes, he's very famous. You can read about him, Stepan Razin. He was, like, very... considered a hero in Soviet times because the communists, like, respected all the, like, revolution people even from old times. You see, it cost just 48 cents. But, again, for... Not for a liter, half a liter, but just... 450 milliliters again. But here you see the pear and syrup. I've never tried pear and syrup, you know, $1.64. So I'll take it because I tried peaches, I tried pineapples, but not pears. Yeah, let's go further. Here is the wine, you see, alcohol. For example, this wine called Isabella the Beautiful cost $1.75, you see. And here we see the chicken canned meat, 68 cents for such a can. I've heard canned meat is not very good in this shop, but still, you see, cow meat, $1.52, but this one says it's like good sort. You know, the best sort. Maybe this one is not bad, so I'll take it. And doesn't seem too cheap, you know. So maybe this one is good. But here, like, quite cheaper ones. Oh, you see, pig meat. Canned meat. You see, so nice. Piggy. Very beautiful pig. I want to hug it and kiss it. You see, but pig meat is cheaper. 65 cents. Maybe mama, lots of fat inside. And here is, like, you see, is a replacement for Sprite, Russian Sprite, 45 cents for such a bottle called Lime Lemon. You see many different brands now. And this is Unijuice Cola, you see, one more replacement of Coca-Cola. But this one is the cheapest, just 24 cents, crazy cheap. I wonder if it's good or not, I decided not to take it by some reason. Yeah, and this is... another replacement of Fanta, you see, but it's called Fonte, not Fanta, but Fonte. And this is another one, Tanger Eagle, 47 cents, another replacement of Fanta. Fonte I didn't see, maybe sold out. But here you see Kvass, 3 liters Kvass, you see it's like in America, crazy big bottles they sell in these supermarkets. Cost dollars, 2 cents for 3 liters, crazy big. And this brand is kind of famous, Russian Dar. Okay, time to buy the stuff. And I like this shop, they don't have this stupid membership cards, you know. I hate this membership cards, but here they don't have it. Okay, let's go, but you know, I need still some fresh fruits or vegetables. Some grandma sells some vegetables here. How much it cost, I wonder. So let's buy from her. Oh, bananas. Здравствуйте, а вы здесь, да? А можно мне вот морковки штук 5? Нет, по среднюю. Упс. Давайте. Хватит? Да. А, ну вот, можно мандарин штук там 8.
Выбирать надо. А.
Ну, внутри они нормальные, я думаю.
Еще что?
А вот это что такое?
Это желтая морковь.
Желтая морковь?
Для плова.
А. Давайте, да, я вкус я помню. Я думал, в чем секрет вкуса такого? А? Ну, попробовать там маленькую какую-нибудь среднюю. Так просто не едят?
Едят, почему она вкусная?
А, давайте одну попробую просто. Или две, давайте две.
Редко бывает.
А, все, сколько всего? Ага, сейчас. So guys, let's count how much it all cost me. This carrot plus oranges and plus this yellow carrot, guys, I didn't even know such carrot exists. This bag cost me 106 rubles, like it's dollar something, you know. And then you see in this shop, supermarket, Svetofor, you see they even sell, oh, the airplane, the airport not far from here. Good that it's not the drone, you know, nowadays. But you see they even have cheap bags, but not good quality bags. But you see usually in supermarkets you have a name of the supermarket, but here there is nothing. And like transparent bags. So guys, this bag, one bag cost 2 rubles 57 kopecks. It's 2-3 times cheaper than in other supermarkets. When, like, you know, when you buy a bag, plastic bag, it usually costs 5 rubles, sometimes even 7 rubles. So it's 2 times cheaper here. But you see, the quality of bags also not so good. They're much easier to cut. Already I cut one. So yeah, guys, what can I say about such supermarket? You know, it's actually better than I thought. You can buy, especially like some, you know, if you need some big stuff, like for a big family, you see people come here by car, because for some people who are poor, low income people, you know, they don't have car to come here. So it's not only for poor people. So this store, so, you know, for some people is good, even to me. You see, I got some lots of stuff here. Yeah, my car sharing car, you see, right? You can take car sharing cars and push like, because you see I spend money for you. I took a car to film this video. So in the end, guys, all of these two bags cost me 1,855 rubles 79 kopecks. You see. What do you think, how much would it cost in America? Tucker Carlson, what his shop in this store You know, look in such an area. Блять. Looks like it's closed. Yeah, Russia, you know, is not as clean as American roads. I mean, New York is kind of trashy city, for example, but you hardly ever have such like dirt in America, you know. But guys, that's not all. Let me show you another supermarket of this brand, Svetofor, which locates not very far. So I'll show you how it looks in general, you know, that it's located in some outskirts, and we're not gonna shop anymore there, but I'll just show you the location, why they choose this kind of outskirts locations, and it's one of the reasons why they keep prices low. Let's go. Okay guys, you see some Z people come here also to such a shop. Guys, look, some Chinese car, very funny, Cherry, but I'm driving Haval, it's also Chinese company, but produced in Belarus nowadays. Okay, let's go to other supermarket of this brand, Svetofor, but in another location. Crazy holes, guys. Oh, look, guys, some dog is protecting the area, probably. Wow, Lada cars. So you can see, guys, this apartment here in the outskirts cost much cheaper, but at the same time, there is no like transport or anything here. So it's cheap apartments, but it's hard to get out from here, you know, and very big traffic lines. You know, even lines for the bus to leave in the morning to the job, to your work. Well, look what they have here. Some picture on the... this so-called Putinko's apartments, you see. 25 stories, 30 floors. And they build them in the outskirts without any road infrastructure and so on. And now it's like daytime and still traffic to leave this hood, you know. Because no infrastructure and so on. Chinese cars are conquering Russia. So guys, I'm looking for it but can't find it. I think maybe it's here. Yeah, maybe it's here. Some factory territory. Let's turn. Oh my god, it's crazy here. Oh wow. Yeah, probably it's here, some factory territory. Let's see. Yeah, it should be here. I saw this blue building on the map. Yeah, here it is. Would you love, guys, to visit such supermarkets? Well, if the road was good... Well, you see, here is like some factory. Cement factory, I think. Here it is, Svetofor. Adidas. Okay, let me show you first, even though I think it's not good to park here. So yeah guys, that's another Svetofor here. Let's just quickly check it out, how it looks. You see where it locates. Светофор. Wow, this one has even modern design, you see, like in space station. Let's buy something very quick, small. Okay, let's buy this. So guys, would you shop inside supermarkets? You see inside areas, but it's cheap, you know. So even I would come here to buy some big pack of let's say soap or powder. Yes, but locations are not so nice. But if I had a car, I would come here. But since I don't have a car, you know, it's no point to come to these shops, because you'll spend more money to come here by, you know, there is no public transport which goes to such locations. And if you have a car, it's profitable, or you need to live nearby somewhere, and like, you know, that's how you can save money in such stores. But yes, it's not as bad. Okay, I go home, guys. Subscribe, push like.